Am I audible at the back? Alright, first, I got placed in Goldman Sachs. What the company does is mainly deals with investment banking and things like security and stocks trading. First of all, it does not expect any FIN prerequisite. So if you're worried about FIN, take it out of your head. Secondly, we'll start off with what my preparation plan was. I started only in October mid, but if you do not know data structures and algorithms, if you're new to competitive programming, it's ideal to start from August. So main things in Goldman Sachs would be, first, this text. So in text, there were a couple of sections. The first one was DXA. It had two questions, if I'm not wrong. One was solvable. Second one, only if you knew DSA, you would be able to solve. So if you are able to solve these two, or at least partially the second one, then it's good for you. Next was the quant, which mainly focused on problem. Before that, the preparation material that I use for data structures and algorithms is mainly interview bit. Try to start this in August so that eventually you will be done by the time you start writing your test. There's another good resource for data structures and algorithms with respect to theory. It's called CodeMonk. It's part of HackerEarth series. It has topic-wise notes as well as sample coding questions. So if you're starting from the beginning, right, it's the best resource that you can use as notes. And then you can directly go and solve interview bit. If you still have time, you could do lead code, medium questions. Mainly you can focus on something called dynamic programming, because every, irrespective of the company, whether it's GS or not, they mainly focus on dynamic programming. So try to practice DP questions. And obviously there's also Geeks for Geeks. So that is regarding the DSA part. The second one is Proverb. There is something called brain stellar Proverb puzzle questions. This is all I solved. Apart from that, this coursework that I did, that should be enough. All you have to do is practice some Proverb questions so that you are able to do within time. Some questions are tricky, so only if you solve questions like from brain stellar, you'll be able to do it in the exam, that is the test. Then, yeah, there was one surprising section. It was behavioral. There were two questions. One was, your teammate fell sick, so how would you ensure that you finish the project within the deadline? That was one question. The second question, was, what achievement are you proud of? So describe a scenario that you went through inside college, and what is it that you're proud of and why, etc. So that is regarding the test part. The second most important thing is obviously the resume. Whether you like it or not, half of the battle is fought even before writing tests. That is the resume, because it's very important when you go to the interview. Almost every company will have one round dedicated to resume, where you focus on projects that you have done and behavioral questions based on this. So this might serve as a starting point for your technical questions. For an instance, it could be based on the project that you have done. They'll find a related problem statement and they would ask you the question and so on, okay? Then the third part is the interview. So GS is mainly infamous for taking a lot of rounds. This time they were lucky. I mean, we got lucky. We had only two or three rounds. Each one spanned from 30 to 40 minutes. I had two rounds. The first round was mainly Proverb and math. It was simple. It was an open-ended question where you had to formulate the problem statement mathematically and give solution to it. So one important thing that you should do is don't think in your mind. Ensure that you talk, have a good conversation. Think of it this way, right? So the person who is interviewing you is your colleague. So they expect you to show how you would solve the problem along with them. But don't keep asking too many questions. Ask whatever is necessary and understand what kind of question you're asking. Please don't ask lame questions as well, because your questions will also be evaluated. So you should ask in such a way that you're getting to the solution easily. And that was the first round. The second round was completely resume, and from there we went to ML and BN. Yeah, one more thing that I missed out is I don't think they ask ML or DL in the test, but sometimes if you have it in the projects, they'll expect ML and DL, or any analytics company will expect basic ML, which is like regression and statistics. For that, the resource that I used is there's something called 100-page machine learning book. It's quite small, so you can finish it in 1 week. Since I started late, I only read this before the interviews. Then the second one would be the obvious coursework or the slides that are present in IIT websites. If you're doing machine learning or deep learning currently, please ensure that you write good notes so that you can revise it later. Any course for that matter out of these, like Proverb, ML and DL, write good notes so that you can revise. Yeah, before that, one important thing regarding applying to companies itself, have a kind of strategy. It can be two ways, right? One, you can be picky and apply to companies that you actually want. So you review the profile and then you think of your chances to get inside, accordingly you apply, because you will save a lot of time from the test. So you can prepare more and focus on that company. That would be one strategy. The second strategy would be, like, there are few people who write a lot of tests and they come back, solve the questions that were asked in the test and get the experience, right? Some people learn questions this way. So whatever it is, decide and do not have regrets, because if you want to apply for more companies, decide early and apply. What I did was I was very picky. I applied only for 15 to 20 companies, but the shortlists weren't out until 4 or 5 days ago. I had only one or two shortlists, which was slightly scary, but eventually the shortlist came. So I would say do not keep it at that level. Try to be not be too picky and not have too many companies, because you should have time for preparation. Yeah, specific do's and don'ts. One important thing would be to get a proper mock interview. So the reason why this is important is, if you're not given internship interviews inside institute, it's essential that you talk to your friends in an interview setting where you bounce questions, right? For instance, the first question that I got asked is, tell me something that's not there in your resume. So it was like an ice-breaking question, right? You shouldn't freak out once you get to that question. And companies like GS or any really competitive 1.1 companies, the main thing that they look for is every word you say matters in their evaluation. So ensure that you are talking in the right manner that you want the interview to go. And obviously do not freak out. Be really calm. That's why, like the previous person was talking during the interview prep, behavior is really important. Write those questions that will be frequently asked and make stories for each of them, so that you would not panic when you get asked that question. For example, so-and-so project is there. What is the most challenging part you had in this project? And what is something that you're not proud of? What is something that you regret a lot, etc. So these kind of questions, you can find them online, or you can also think and imagine what they could ask, right? So ensure that you have this behavior. This is very important, which people don't focus. Tech and behavior are equally important. Do's, yes. So as much as possible, every question is like an opportunity for you to talk about your interests and strengths, such that your interests align to the company, right? They are giving you the opportunity to tell them that I'm the right person for this job. If you give them that much, that should be enough. So you should be able to show your technical caliber and also communication. Regarding the material, I think this is the only material that I did. And apart from that, after every test, I ensure that I knew the solution to that particular question. Because whether you like it or not, most companies will have repeated questions again. So you'll have that edge if you come back and solve those questions. Something that helped me the most during preparation is around October mid, I made a plan as to what I will do and within what time I should finish. So irrespective of how I was doing the test, I did not let it get to my head and I didn't freak out ever throughout the entire process. That was because I had good planning. I would suggest you also to have a good planning. By July, I think you can start refining your resume. Resume is highly important, I cannot stress enough. Because even if you're bad at ML or bad at DL, if you have not done it, If you have good projects and if you are able to talk about it and convince them that you are good, it should be enough. So do ensure that your resume is good. Have it reviewed by several people, because when you review something, right, like when people who have interviewed for that firm review it, they'll know things where it can go wrong. So do ensure that you start preparing your resume early. The changes, if given a chance, the changes that I would make to my prep is almost nothing. It was fine, just that I might have started early. I didn't start early, so that you can start early from August. I think that's about it from my side. If you have any questions now, I can answer.
What is a good resume?
Sorry?
Good resume, what is
it? Okay, objectively good resume. Objectively good resume could be nothing to do with CGPA, first of all. They do not care much about CGPA. Important things would be projects, right? They're coming for analytics profile. So you can expect them that they will look at your ML and DL projects if you have them. Or if you have done anything related to optimization, right? PORs are not very sure if they focus on it. It can be used for behavioral, but the projects are the crux of what they look for. I hope I've answered your question.
And courses.
And courses, yeah, sure. Like you have course projects also, right? You can talk about that as well. So if you've done good projects, feel free to put that in your resume and you'll be able to talk about it. It would help if you have good industry interns. I had done intern in IBM research, which was based on deep learning. And before that, I had done another internship in Flipkart, which is again analytics. So both of them help. If you do not have good internships, you can cover it up with good coursework or projects. Anyone else? Any other question? I saw someone there. I'm from aerospace, dual degree 50. Anything else? Thank you.